Hi, I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and we're going to be taking a look at how we can use Mocha Pro Camera Solve data directly within After Effects. I'm going to show you how to set the scene up and a couple of sample workflows about how we integrate that 3D data inside our After Effects compositions. If you watched the first Getting Started video, then you'll recognize this footage that we're about to work on. This is our round building again. And I've already got this tracked in Mocha Pro. And just to say, this workflow is going to be the same whether you're working in the Mocha Pro plugin or in the standalone Mocha Pro. So in the plugin, I will come in and press the big Mocha button, and it's going to ask me to confirm proxy tracking. So you can see here, the host is not set to full resolution. I'm at quarter res at the moment. So if I hit continue here, then Mocha Pro is only going to be getting a quarter res version of the clip from After Effects. Now, if we're exporting out camera solve data, this is a big no-no because we won't get anything lining up. So instead, I'm just going to click switch to full res, and this is now going to serve the full resolution inside of Mocha Pro. We now have a nice sharp full res Ultra HD version of this clip. Like I said, I've already done the camera solve here, so I'm going to come to the camera solve tab. I'll just turn on 3D up here so we can see that it is solved in. Very nice. I can have a little look at the perspective mode, or actually let's come to the left view, turn on my grid up at the top, and you can see as well that my scene is nicely oriented. So the ground plane is sat on the ground. I change this to the top view. My camera movement is moving from left to right as well. Let's go back into the camera view. Now, taking a little look here, I've used a maximum track count of 320, which is, it's fairly high, but we've got a pretty decent result out of it. We're a fraction over that one HPX error that we were looking for. I think we're gonna be fine. And if we come a look at the features now, you can see we've got 285 vertices to work with. This is a lot. In fact, we can export all of these out, but it's going to really slow down After Effects to do that. So what I would say is that we should just choose the ones that we actually want to take out. Now, there's a few different ways of doing this, but the thought process is always the same. Like, what points do we actually need to do the job that we want to do? So in this case, like, all I really want is a way to identify what the ground plane is. So I'm going to select a few on the ground plane, a few points on the ground at various different depths, or, you know, various different areas around here. And we can see those are selected. Let's just right click on those and give these a different color. I do like orange. If we wanted something to line up with a specific area in the scene as well, we would make sure that we had that selected too. So if I wanted something to come from the wall point over here, then I'd have this wall selected. Similarly, I would take, maybe I'll take this one over here, and what should we say, this one over here as well on the wall. And I'll give this or these another color, just so that it's a lot easier to pick them out of the lineup. Now, we can just turn all of the features off and come in and take the ones that we've selected, or take the ones that we've color coded. Let's take these ones here. Boom, 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 boom. And if I right click, I can toggle with visibility just on those ones. So we've only got these as our visible points. I'm kind of happy with that. So let's export our scene now. So I'm going to click on the big export camera data, and we choose our format. I'm just going to use the After Effects 3D motion data here, and I can choose what I'm going to export out, either selected points, all visible points, or all objects. And I don't want all the objects because that will take in even the ones that I have turned invisible. I just want the visible ones. And here, I'm just going to copy this to the clipboard. And I'm going to get a handy warning dialog box saying that if I want to use this data, I have to install the 3D track importer plugin. Now, I've already done that. But if you haven't, you can click directly on the link, filter by Mocha Pro, and you'll see the Mocha 3D track importer standing right here, which is available for both Windows and Mac OS. Let's hit OK on that to have that data in my clipboard. And I'll exit out of Mocha and I'll be back into my After Effects comp. From here, I'm going to come up to the edit menu, and if I've got that 3D camera importer plugin installed properly, I'll see this paste Mocha camera option down at the bottom. So let's paste that Mocha camera, and that's going to bring in the camera and my nulls. I'll select these all so we can see all the nulls, and they're moving along. Let's color code these a little bit better so it's easier to see them. And let's have the ones on the floor rotated so they're sat to the floor. So I'll just have those selected, hit R, and I can change my orientation to, 90? Or maybe even minus 90, so they're all pointing upwards. Now, if we've got a lot of nulls, this can start to, you know, clog up our composition a little bit. So what I like to do is just to have these nulls selected and turn on the shy guy here so that I can hide those in the timeline whenever I need to, whenever I don't want to see them. And just to make things easier for me, I'm going to lock my Mocha camera and I'm going to lock the background video as well, so I don't accidentally select that and move that out of the way. And that's it. That's how we've got our Mocha camera data plus any of the features imported into After Effects. But let's have a look at how we can use these for a couple of practical things. The first thing I'm going to do is add an object in here to match move, and I'm going to maybe match it to this particular point. I have the point or points selected, and I am going to cut that with Control or Command X, and then immediately paste it back in again with Control or Command V. And this puts it up at the top. Let's give that a different color. And let's find something that we want to track in. Let's just add in our Mocha logo. I'm going to turn this into 3D. It's going to be somewhere. We don't know where it is. It's just going to be somewhere. So we want to match it to this point here. So we can open this up, and I'm going to copy the position, Control or Command C, from that null and paste it. So we now know that that's sat in about the right place. Well, the right place in Z. Probably want to move it up a little bit so it's sat on the ground. How do we find out where the ground is? Well, let's turn this into two views here, and I'll zoom in using the middle mouse button. And we can see, because I imported a few different feature points that were all sat on the ground plane, we get a nice idea about where that ground plane actually is. So I can move this up, shift this up until it's sat on our ground plane here. I can even use the widgets just to twiddle that around a little bit. So long as I keep that Z distance correct, like, we'll still have that nice same movement with the camera. And that's fitting in quite nicely. Well, what if we wanted to add in a light and cast a realistic shadow from this object? Well, we can do that as well. And I'm going to create a layer to use as a shadow catcher. But first, a quick word of warning. If I go into my composition settings and come into my 3D renderer, I actually have three types of renderer. I have classic 3D, which is the traditional After Effects renderer. I have the advanced 3D, and I have the Cinema 4D 3D. And each of these renderers allows us to do different things. Now, the way I'm going to create the shadow catcher needs for me to accept shadows only. And under the disabled features on Cinema 4D, you can see accept shadows only is disabled. In advanced 3D, accepts shadows only is disabled. In classic 3D, we can do our little traditional shadow catcher. All of this is to say, if you can't see the options I'm showing you here, it's probably because you need to go into your advanced composition settings. All right, well, let's create a new shape layer. And I'm just going to double click on my rectangle tool with the fill at white, and I'll call this one Shadow Catcher. I'll move this into 3D, and I think I've still got that position data in my clipboard, so I'm just going to paste that in there. Yep, and that moves that into the right 3D space. So let's just reorient this, minus 90. There we go, lovely. And if we take a look at our second view, our left-hand view, you can see that's just sat directly on the ground plane. Because we set the scene up properly in Mocha, everything's looking good here. I'm just going to turn this back to one view again and hide all of my nulls with the shy guy. Okay, let's add in a new light now. I'm going to make this point light. I'm not going to have any fall off to begin with. We'll come into that later. And I'm going to make sure it casts shadows. Take the shadow diffusion to zero. I'll keep my shadow darkness up high so we can see what this is doing. And the lights are automatically set to 3D, so let's find a good place for it to go to. let's actually open up the position on this one here, copy that, paste it into the light, and let's bring my light up. And we start to see that is now throwing some light onto my ground plane. And here's where we want to set up our materials inside of After Effects to make sure that it's doing what we want it to do. So the first thing to do is have a look at our shadow catcher, open this up. And at the bottom here, we can see material options. So we have options for cast shadows, it's currently set to off, accept shadows, currently set to on, and accept lights, which is also currently set to on. So we can see that it is now accepting a light and accepting a shadow. Nothing's casting a shadow on it, so we have no shadows. But under this accept shadows, I'm going to click on where it says on, and I'm going to set this to only. So it's only going to accept shadows. I'll turn my accept lights off as well. So now we have a ground plane that is only going to accept shadows when they are cast. So why we're not seeing any shadows being cast? Well, let's come over to our other 3D layer in the scene, which is our logo. And we can see here that the cast shadows is set to off. So if I set this to on, we can see our logo is now casting shadows. We can't really see the logo, and the reason for that is that we have lights turned on as well, and we're not, you know, shining anything else on that light. So let's turn that lights to off, so we're just seeing the light cast the shadows from our layer. All right, well, let's animate this light up. There we go. We can definitely see that that light is moving around. Well, we can infer that that light is moving around because the shadow is moving. But well, let's see how we can make a visible light, shall we? Now, this isn't really involved in Mocha Pro, but it's a nice way of seeing that we can actually visualize this this data. And I'm just going to come in. I'm just going to use a sapphire lens flare and set my mode to 3D, so it's going to pick up from the point light. I'll just set this mode to screen, and maybe I'll just make the width a little bit smaller. There we go. So we can actually visualize what's going on with this. I've wanted to make some changes to the shadow. Of course, we can come in and we can double click on the light and make those changes there. Like I changed my fall off, add a little bit of diffusion on there just to soften it out a little bit. And of course, this is just the basics of what you can do. You can start to link up any effects that have 3D available to them, or you can reposition things in 3D space, masking them off as you need to, as I've done with this tree. This is quite a fun one. Or just build on the ideas as you've already seen. Once you've got the data from the Mocha Pro Camera Solve, it's yours to do with as you will. So explore, have fun, experiment. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'll see you again in 3D very soon. Bye for now. If you've got a question or want to know how to do something with the Camera Solve, let us know in the comments below. We're always really interested in what you'd like to see. And of course, if you haven't got Mocha Pro yet and you want to see what you can do, head on over to borisfx.com for a free trial version.